okay, I think these are headphones, not earbuds or iPods. My kids always make fun of me. I'm going to start with the circle, but I want it to be a little bit more of an ovalish in the width of the circle. And then I've got about halfway down to that left outer side of that circle. We just have this kind of slope organic shape. I'm drawing light just to get these proportions right. And I really want the resting headphone to come to the, I would say, top third of that first headphone that we did, so that earpiece. And so you really want to look at the starting and stopping places when you're overlapping shapes or objects together. And then I just have a nice negative space that's kind of rectangular in between the two, and that helps me get that little earpiece that comes out and then comes down to the cord. Oh my gosh, I should figure out what these are called. And then I just have the mesh part of the headphone. And so we have two circles within the circle, but they come to the right side. And so once I get those shapes kind of close-ish, or I'm happy with them, I'm just going to go back through and do the detail. I like to outline any areas that I'm going to add value. And then that top cord, just the gesture that it's coming out behind. And then I've given this illusion that one piece is in front, the other is resting on top and behind, and then the cord to the right is coming out behind. Once I'm happy with my shapes, happy-ish I should say, I'm going to outline them a little bit darker. And I, of course, start with really light value, and then I'm just going to build it up and decide what areas I want darker and lighter. And drop a little bit of a cast shadow. And I'm really careful when I shade this small that I have a nice, clean, sharp tip. And make sure my values match. Like everything on the left side should be a little bit darker than the right side, because I'm giving the idea that that's where my light source is coming from. And once I'm happy, I am done.